Getting started with Google Drive. So to log into Google Drive, all you have to do is open a web browser and type in drive.google.com. And you'll be logged into My Drive. If you're coming from your emails as well, another way that you can go straight to Drive is click on the waffle button and then click on Drive. So this is what the Google Drive interface looks like. Let's have a look. Top left-hand corner, you have the New button. If you click on this, here is where you can create new folders, create new documents, sheets and slides, and also upload files and folders. Underneath this, you have Priority View, and this is where Google stores your most relevant documents, and you can also create customizable workspaces. We'll go through this in a future video. Underneath Priority is My Drive, and this is like my documents on the computer. So Google Drive is essentially like your computer, but online. It's kind of like Dropbox, and you can upload not just Google documents, but PDFs, videos, photos, anything that you want, really. So it just acts like a computer. So the easiest way to think of My Drive is like my documents on the computer. And you can even press a little arrow there to expand, and you can see your subfolders just as you would on your local desktop. Underneath My Drive, we have shared drives. And this used to be called team drives. It's now called share drives. And the difference between shared drives and My Drive is that you own the stuff in My Drive, whereas the team owns the stuff in shared drive. This way, if you have a team member that joins you or a team member that leaves your team, it doesn't really matter because none of the files will be affected and the rest of the team can keep working as they did. Underneath that, we have shared with me. And this shows a history of all the different files that were shared with you from other people. Then we have recent, which shows a history of what you opened recently. And starred, you can put stars on certain documents that you use a lot or you go into a lot. And then the bin, which is the trash. But let's go into My Drive again. Let's go to the right-hand side here. This button here will toggle between grid view and list view. So at the moment, you can see that the documents are in a list. If you prefer to see it in grid view, click that, and you'll be able to kind of see more of what's on your Google Drive. Let's put it back to list view. The eye here shows information and details about each document. So if I just kind of click on this, and I want to click on the information, I'll be able to see the activity and also the details. I'll just cross that off there. You may have noticed when I click on this document, these other icons popped up. So this is a way of sharing by link. This is a way of sharing to another person as well. This is a way you can quickly preview the document, like that, and the bin, as well as other actions in here. So we will go through all these and then also these ones on the left in more details a bit later. So don't freak out about that. But this is the basics of Google Drive and what the interface looks like. So if you remember it as being kind of like your My Documents on your computer, but online, it's really good because it's accessible anywhere as long as you have internet. And you don't have to worry about losing any files because they're all saved online. And let's continue talking about Google Drive in the next video.
If you like this content, please hit subscribe and hit the bell notification so you can be notified when we go live or drop new content on the channel. Now, if you'd like to connect with us, hit us up on social media or join our free community group. All the links to that are right below this video. If you'd like to learn more about Google Workspace and the technology ecosystem, you can join our free Genius Academy by transferring your billing across to itGenius. Or you can join a Workspace Basics Bootcamp. Now, if you're a business owner and you're interested in an audit on your technology stack or your Workspace account, or you're looking to do a project in the tech world, well, you can take advantage of our free consultation. And if you need help right now, then consider joining Concierge or taking up a quick fix with our team for professional support for your tech stack.